Okay, greetings YouTube land. I'm Falagar and welcome back to another Let's Play of Klaxx the MALIGN in Skyrim. And so the last time I just got out of the... there goes my Draugr horde. What was that? Bleak's Falls Barrow, right? And I went in there initially with a couple of saber cats and some bandits and some other things and... came out of it with Draugr, because as I mentioned in the last episode, that's how it seems like it's going to go. You know, sometimes you can go into one dungeon with a certain theme of undead and come out with a totally different theme, especially when you start losing undead along the way. You know, something that I haven't really been... I've been conscious of it, but something I haven't been devoting too much attention to is the spells and the skills that I'm going to use as a necromancer. I know one thing for sure is a necromancy, and I want to get all of the different I don't know what the levels of necromancy, you know, like novice, apprentice, and all that. I don't think I'm going to be summoning Itranach, but I think I'm going to summon Dramora Lords. I think I'm going to do that. And then there's, I think it's called Twin Souls, where I can have summon two things, like two undead or two Dramora. So here's what I'm thinking. I'm going to, there's almost really no need for me to, you know, cast like Reanimate Dead and Revenant and stuff like that. I can reserve... you know, the conjuration aspect of my spells, you know, limited to like the bound sword, which I have right here, as well as you know, summon Dromora Lord. And I think, you know, that might change, but I think that should do it really, because when it comes to summoning the undead, that's coming from my ritual stone. Unless there's really not a lot of corpses around, and I guess if I absolutely have to, I'll, you know, do like a reanimate corpse or something. You know, it's only 30 or 60 seconds, but of course when the corpse expires, it turns to ash. And what was the other thing I was going to say too was, I don't want to really do Atronach. Oh, and a dead thrall. I don't think I'm going to do that. And the reason why, I discovered through some research last night, I think it caps the level that you can revive a dead or reanimate a corpse, but not reanimate corpse, but to cast Dead Thrall on. Because what Dead Thrall does, it's called Dead Thrall. I was wrong. It was not called Revenant. Revenant, I think, is an upgraded version of reanimate corpse. What Dead Thrall does, you can raise the dead, and it would be a permanent follower until it dies. And I believe when it does die, the corpse does not turn to ash. So you can just cast it again. And it only, here's the rub, it only works on humans, humanoid NPCs. So it doesn't work on animals, which is very odd, because how come this stuff before it, like Reanimate Corpse, Revenant, works on anything, yet Dead Thrall will only work on humanoids? And I don't know if that means just like literally human races like Bretons and Nords and stuff like that, and maybe not on orcs. I'm not too sure of Falmer, but I know it won't work on animals and you know, just creatures and stuff like that, which that sucks. So why mess with that when I just have you know, the ritual stone, and I can just reanimate all corpses around me, and that will serve as my army of the dead. Second, I want to finally get a follower, and I think I'm going to progress a little bit into the College of Winterhold questline, at least complete Sarthal, so that way not only get the Gunder amulet, but there's another amulet that I have in mind that I'm going to use, but I want to get Berlina as a follower temporarily. She'll probably stick with me for a pretty good long while, because she could summon. And that's good, you know, more power to the my undead horde, although she'll actually be summoning Atronachs, And like, I think it's a familiar, which is like the spectral wolf. And that's fine. You know, she can do that because me, I stick to like undead and Daedra. So hence, you know, Dramora Lord. And later on, I'm going to drop her and get someone else. But third thing that's bothering me is I still cannot find Vigilance. And like I said, I think I accidentally killed him, but it's just the not knowing that bothers me. And the only way to really find out for sure is if I come across another stray dog, or if I come across Miko is another dog. And if it says that I already have another dog follower, then we know that Vigilance is somewhere lost in limbo. And that's not good. And that would have totally made the dog companion slot useless, because I think you, yeah, that's right, you can have a dog and you can have a follower. They're two separate companion slots. I think with Dawnguard you get a cave troll. Oh, this is cool. It just looks like it's coming out of my eyes, right? Like heat vision or something. And I think that takes the spot of a dog companion, I think. Okay, so before we begin, let's see here. How do I want to do this? Okay, my health doesn't seem to be too much of an issue for now. I want to be able to still cast some things. So I think I'll get my Magicka up to at least maybe 200, 300, somewhere around that range. I do have to get Destruction, because I tried at the very beginning to play, I tried my best to, although I found myself having to delve into the Destruction tree line, you know, with the Shock Spell, and I think that's okay. I think I may have to still rely on that, because, you know, if I don't have, there might come a point where I won't have an undead horde. Maybe I wasn't paying attention, or I just totally lost them, or they just won't follow me to a certain point. I'm going to have to create a fresh corpse. So I guess it would help my companion, or say if I don't have a companion yet, for me to kill something. I mean, I have my bound weapon, but I would like to whittle down that health from afar, and that would help if I use destruction magic like shock. Fire, maybe not so much, but I think shock is a good one. I'm thinking about it, but I still don't know. I already put a point in this, right? Okay, because did I put a point in this? No. Okay. But yeah, because I guess I should have like a shock, right? Dual casting overcharges the spell, allowing it to last longer for my bound sword. Okay, now this is interesting. Can summon Atronach or raise dead twice as far away? Well, that I'm shooting it, so there really isn't a range. I could cast that. I mean, it works for Atronach, I could see it, but not for raise undead, because that's a bolt that I shoot. Oh, here we go. Greater duration for reanimated dead. Okay, I may... What is this? Bound weapons will banish summoned creatures and turn raised ones. So that's important. Dark souls. Yeah, twin souls is... Atronach, conjured Atronach are 50% more powerful. Can have two Atronach or reanimated zombies. Okay, necromancy. Oh, and this will work together with my ritual, because I believe the skills and your perks are linked to that ritual stone. The types of how powerful your undead are that you summon with the ritual stone. Hopefully that's the case. Well, regardless, I'm gonna need it to get that anyways. So, yeah. Okay, restoration is important. regeneration, heal 50% more. Respite. That's, oh, I keep going all over the place here. Healing also restores stamina. That's good. Oh, come on. That's so hard to navigate this. Okay, so that's good. That might be good for now. Okay. All right. That might be good for now. Save it. Animate the undead. Great. Okay. Let us go, gentlemen. And I'm recording, okay? I'm recording. Need to learn to lock the door. Remove it. I don't know why I don't just lock the door. I think it's because just in case my brother wants to come in and grab something in here. Like he has some of his books there. Oh, this is great. Will the Draugr go into the water? Oh, looks as if they will. You see, this is what I'm talking about. My army is now dead somewhere. Are they fighting? Oh, here comes my undead zombie horde. Let's see. I don't want to totally base my entire play style around my horde, by which I mean having to always like wait up for them every single time and, you know, revive them. I'm going to try to make it almost as natural as possible. Expired. They're floating somewhere. That is okay. So it was very short-lived, my Draugr horde. Such a shame too, I had a...
I've been looking for you.
Oh.
Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. Ah, a letter from the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh? Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Okay. Let's see what that is. Which I'm pretty sure it's from... Yep. From Falkreath, talking about the property. Klaxx the Malign. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sidgir, and I have the honor to be the Jarl of the proud and ancient city of Falkreath. The fame of your exploits across Skyrim has brought you to my attention. If you are interested in becoming a Thane of Falkreath Hold, I invite you to speak to me the next time you are in Falkreath. Aside from the honor that accrues to the title, my Thanes are entitled to a personal housecarl. I also can tell you privately that a choice parcel of land in Falkreath would be available for your purchase should your services prove useful to me. I look forward to meeting you in person. I remain Jarl Sidgir of Falkreath. To sell to. Yeah, I do. And why is this not favorites? Yeah, unfavorites that. Excellent.
Riverwood Trader is everything you need in a general store. My sister Camilla or I will be happy to help you.
Yes, I was here earlier and I saw you and your daughter were arguing. What happened?
We did have a bit of a break-in. We still have plenty to sell. Robbers were only after one thing. An ornament, solid gold in the shape of a dragon's claw.
Do you mean this golden claw?
You found it! There it is! Strange. It seems smaller than I remember. Funny thing, huh? I'm gonna put this back where it belongs.
Behind glass. Behind lock and key, right? So it won't get stolen again. Or just on the desk where someone can take it.
Thank you so much for taking care of those thieves. The Riverwood Trader is back to the way it used to be. Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
Keep the bolts for now, because those are kind of hard to come by. Just in case, you never know if I may use a crossbow. Chances are no. Okay, boots. Why am I not? Okay, because I'm using those. have. This I know I can get for free. The clairvoyance can be helpful sometimes, though. Despite the fact that you have the quest marker, sometimes you don't know exactly how to get there, the path. And that can help. Ooh. I have this already, right? Yeah.
Next time. You and me, we're the only... Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
I'll keep one, though, as maybe I can keep it on the shelf. I have a collection of these.
All right, then.
You there. The Dawnguard is looking for anyone willing to fight against the growing vampire menace. What do you say?
Killing vampires. I have not noticed any vampire menace.
You're not paying attention then, like almost everyone else around here. Haven't you heard that the Hall of the Vigilance was destroyed by vampires? They never took the threat seriously, and now they've paid the price.
Vigilance. Dawn Guard? What do you speak of?
The Vigilance mostly hunt down Daedra worshippers, which is why they got torn to pieces when they went up against vampires. That's why our leader, Ezron, is re-establishing the Dawn Guard. Real, serious vampire hunters.
Interesting. Sure, I'll play along for now. Killing vampires. Where do I sign up?
Ha! Ezron's going to like you.
I'll see how this plays out.
Dawnguard.
This could
southeast of Rift. He'll decide if
prove,
Dawnguard material.
To my advantage. Maybe not necessarily to join the Dawn Guard, but maybe to get a closer look at this vampire threat of which he speaks.
Are you finished ogling the grotesque? I suppose I should be grateful you didn't simply attack me.
Because of my robes. Right? There is something of interest to me actually in Windhelm. But I don't have to get that right now. where that is. I do remember there is random ore up here somewhere. There it is.
City's closed with the dragons about. Official business only.
Let me pass. I have news of Helgen and the dragon attack.
Fine. But we'll be keeping an eye on you.
Takes, but we must have more swords for the Imperial soldiers.
I just can't fill an order that size on my own.
Under Ben might need a Ulfric Stormcloak.
Whoa.
Besides,
sorry about that.
Braymane would never make steel for the Legion.
Have it your way. I'll take the job, but don't expect a miracle.
I ended it because I thought it was going to lock up, and when that happens, I lose the recording. You know, so I panicked. So it looked like it stuttered for a moment there. So, that's not a problem. All I have to do is just connect it.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something. In the old fort near Riften.
I heard about that too. This is news that cannot wait. And am I afflicted with something? Yeah, ataxia. Fix me right up.
Say Helgen got hit by a dragon. One of those horrors comes here. We'll be ready.
And I just want you guys to see that, of course, it is still on legendary. So I did reduce it to novice the one time, but that was just to complete the Lost to the Ages quest, which was glitched for me, but I managed to work around it. And in a way, it's still somewhat glitched because of the fact that they did not put it down here on my quest completed log.
What would you have me do then? Nothing?
My lord, please.
Comes trouble.
What's the meaning of this interruption? Jarl Balgruuf is not receiving visitors.
Who's this then?
Step aside, fellow Dunmer. I have news from Helgen about the dragon attack, for I was there.
Well, that explains why the guards let you in. Come on then, the Jarl will want to speak to you personally.
I'm sure he would.
you were at Helgen. You saw this dragon with your own eyes?
Indeed, 'twas the last thing I saw as the Imperial soldiers were about to chop my head off.
Really? You're certainly forthright about your criminal past. But it's none of my concern who the Imperials want to execute, especially now. What I want to know is, what exactly happened at Helgen?
Indeed. Well, the dragon, as I said, the dragon destroyed Helgen, and last I saw, it was headed this way.
By Ysmir, Ireleth was right. What do you say now prevents us? Shall we continue to trust in the strength of our walls against the dragon?
My lord, we should send troops to Riverwood at once. It's in the most immediate danger. If
the Jarl
of Balgruuf will
view that as a provocation. He'll assume we're preparing to join Ulfric's side and attack him. We should
not. I'll not stand idly by while the dragon burns my hold and slaughters my people. Ireleth, send a detachment to Riverwood at once.
Yes, my Jarl.
If you'll excuse me, I'll return to my duties.
That would be best. Well done. You sought me out on your own initiative. You've done Whiterun a service. I won't forget it. Here, take this as a
means
small
to an end
of my esteem. There is another thing you could do for me. Suitable for someone of your particular talents, perhaps. Come, let's go find Falagar, my court wizard. He's been looking into a matter related to these dragons and rumors of dragons.
Very well. Always interested in meeting a fellow mage, especially one with a different practice than I.
I think I've found someone who can help you with your dragon project. Go ahead and fill him in with all the details.
So the Jarl thinks you can be of use to me. Oh yes, he must be referring to my research into the dragons. Yes, I could use someone to fetch something for me. Well, when I say fetch, I really mean delve into a dangerous ruin in search of an ancient stone tablet that may or may not actually be there.
And what does this stone tablet have to do with the dragons?
Ah, no mere brute mercenary, but a thinker. Perhaps even a scholar? You see, when the stories
Something
of
like
dragons
that.
Began to circulate, many dismissed them as mere fantasies, rumors, impossibilities. One sure mark of a fool is to dismiss anything that falls outside his experience as being impossible. But I began to search for information about dragons. Where had they gone all those years ago? And where were they coming from?
And what is it that you need me to do?
I, learned of a certain stone tablet said to be housed in Bleak Falls Barrow. A Dragonstone, said to contain a map of dragon burial sites. Go to Bleak Falls Barrow, find this tablet,
I was just there.
No doubt interred in the main chamber, and bring it to me. Simplicity itself.
I'm already ahead of you.
Ah, the Dragonstone of Bleak Falls Barrow. You already found it. You are cut from a different cloth than the usual brutes the Jarl foists on me.
So now what?
That is where your job ends and mine begins. The work of the mind. Sadly undervalued in Skyrim.
Well, what are you saying?
Falagar.
Well, in the meantime, I'll go ahead and disenchant some things.
Falagar.